When it started getting bad in college, when I was tired all the time and was experiencing the chronic fatigue, I thought I was just stressed out. And I was still getting rashes. I thought the rashes were due to stress. Because, you know, I'm a college student, it was going into my senior year. I was working on a literary magazine, working for a newspaper, taking on 18 credits. So I'm like, I'm just stressed out. Once I graduate, everything will be fine. Because I kept going to doctors thinking something was wrong, and they run tests and they told me you're perfectly healthy. There's nothing wrong with you. So I figured once I graduate, everything will be fine, but it didn't go away.
I blamed myself for my illness because I thought that it was a lifestyle issue.
I remember one time I went to a doctor and I described all my symptoms. He patted me on the leg and said, "Oh, it sounds like you're in love."
Oh, and here's a good one. They asked if you're married. Are you married? Yes, I'm married. Well, are you having marital problems? What does that got to do with anything?
You don't know how many times they told me that you look fine. You look healthy. There's nothing wrong with you. You're too young to have these symptoms. There's nothing wrong. They kept telling me I just need to relax. Maybe I should take some time off school, some time off work, get some rest, and I'll be fine. And with them telling me that my blood work was normal, I had to believe them, you know, because they're the doctors. I figured they knew what they were talking about.
About 10 months into this process, I wound up in Brooklyn at Downstate Medical Center. I forget who had recommended, which doctor had recommended that I go. And at that time, I guess I was in my mid-30s. By then, both of my cousins, also in their mid-30s, had died. And he was taking my history, looking at me, and I said, "Do you think possibly it can't be just nerves? It can't be just imagination?" And I said, "Could this be that I'm going into menopause?" I was looking for any reason that I felt increasingly poorly. And I remember him saying to me, "Oh, are you afraid of getting old?" And started to write something down. And I said, "No, I think I'm afraid of not getting old. And I would like to know what this is."
I felt like they were not taking me serious. They were not taking me serious because I'm a female, or because I'm Hispanic, or because, you know, I'm not high class. You're in the middle. And that really hurt. That hurt me a lot. You know, for me to tell somebody this is what I'm feeling and they tell me it's in my head. No, it's not in my head.
Her fingers started swelling up. She couldn't open the door. She was cold.
Even though I was in the hospital, that really upset me because I'm in the hospital and I couldn't get to certain parts of the hospital because I couldn't open the door. So I had to wait till someone come by and
she was getting the claw thing. Arthritis was so bad and they were taking tests and telling her actually she didn't have arthritis.
Even though years before I had had a malignancy on the bottom of my foot when Michael, my younger son, was born and had had to deal at very young, at the age of 26, 27, with the idea that I had cancer, you know, the big C. That hadn't fazed me. A year on crutches didn't faze me. But these physicians were not aware of that. They didn't know me. And when I said, "I don't look the same," and they knew that I'd been a performer, I suppose it was very easy for them to dismiss it and say, you know, her face has changed, she's getting thinner or she's getting eventually fatter. It must be pride.
I got to the point that I have told doctors, I stopped them in their tracks and I told them, "You know what? I see I'm wasting my time and yours. I think I better leave. And I'll get up and go."
I did a post-Labor Day, what was an annual get-together, a dinner for 12 or 14 of our friends. Among the friends who was there was a very dear friend who happened to be, of all things, a proctological surgeon, who also is a heck of a good diagnostician.
You know, she had lupus.
Lupus, AIDS, sarcoidosis.
Tuberculosis.
They put me in a room alone, isolated room, because I was coughing.
And told me I had to wear a mask to see my own child. If I was with her and she coughed for 6 months, then why wouldn't I have tuberculosis too, if she had tuberculosis, you know? I didn't have tuberculosis.
So the doctors were afraid to come near me because they couldn't understand why I was coughing.
He said, have you seen a doctor? And at that point, I started to cry. I think all of the frustration came out in that one question. Had I seen a doctor, as though somehow or other it were my fault if I had not. And I said, well, if you're giving me a diagnosis, you're number 14. Except I haven't had a diagnosis.
It just so happened that while I was in the hospital the first time with that paralysis, they did a spinal tap. The results of that test came through after I was released. The results of that test showed that I had oligoclonal banding in my spinal fluid, which indicates MS. But no one qualified read that lab report. The knowledge was evident at that time, but that file, that report went into a file and was not found for 10 years.
So he said, well, I think I know what you have. And I braced myself to find out what it was I had. And he said, I think you have something called Graves' disease, which in itself sounded fairly grave, but I wasn't sure of what that really meant. And I said, well, how grave is it?
7 to 10 years. Oh, yeah. 7 to 10 years. I mean, from one doctor to the other and the other. And I mean, I look for specialists. You know, it's so many things for them to tell me now, all this time I've had it, and now they're telling me now? Because I had to get angry?
I emphatically believe that in our current medical system, you know, we get lab results and there are these reference ranges, and physicians look at the reference range and they say, well, you're perfectly fine. Maybe you're a little bit low in iron, or maybe you're a little bit high in this. You're perfectly fine. And I think there's a big problem with that when you have a chronic condition. There may be reference ranges, but you have to look at what's normal for the patient.
We have a very big problem with the ignorance of the medical profession about autoimmune disorders. We have a very big problem with the fact that all these symptoms do not fall within the jurisdiction of any one particular specialist.
It has gotten to the point where it is so overly specialized that it's very difficult to get a true diagnosis.
The ignorance doesn't work as it is, but the managed care thing makes it worse.
So, started this project 10 years ago. I'm starting a new chapter in less than 2 weeks. I'm going for a second master's, this time in public administration. I'm going to see how far I can get in getting some legislation that I think would be really useful for people like me. But I need to get this project done. I can't move on to the next chapter until I've closed that chapter, or at least gotten it to a point where I can see the end in sight. So I'm taking a week off of work, and instead of going and sitting on a beach, I'm taking myself up to Maine to sit on a deck overlooking some water, where I will edit as much as I can possibly edit in 5 days.